Hi, I'm Nick Priegnitz with DuramaxTuner.com, and today's Diesel Insights is going to be on the LB7 injector. Commonly referred to as the worst RPO for injector failure, I think we need to dive into it a little bit and talk about what's going on here. So if you talk to most of the experts about LB7 injector failures, what they're going to come back to you and tell you is that it's caused by fuel system contamination. Poor fuel system maintenance or fuel system contamination is going to lead to water or contaminants or dirt getting into the fuel system, and you have fuel under like 23,000 PSI here, so you have very high loads in the system. You have this contaminants moving through the fuel system, you know, you're going to cause erosion, poor sealing on internal metal parts, pitting, all sorts of bad things are going to happen inside the injector when you have contaminants in the fuel system. Next cause of injector failure is going to be internal wear caused by low lubricity. So similar to the contamination, but this time because we don't have enough lubricity in the fuel system. If you have this low lubricity, you have, again, wear in the fuel system prematurely, and you lose consistency, you lose precision, you lose the ability for the injector to do its job properly. Next failure in the injection system is going to be on, more on the top side of the injector. So this is where the fuel line seats on the injector, where that torque takes place. It's a torque to spec setup. Oftentimes those are over torqued or those injection lines are reused. When that happens, you have the potential to have leaks on the high pressure side of the injector. When you have those leaks on the high pressure side of the injector, that fuel goes right into the crankcase. Again, losing performance in the injection system, fuel in the crankcase, it's all a bad situation. Cascades into much worse things. Okay, and then the last major cause of an LB7 injector failure is going to be more of a factory issue. So 2001 to 2007, the ball seat, which is an internal part sealing the injector, was not hardened. In 2007, they went to a chrome hardened ball seat. If you have one of these earlier injectors, you're going to get less life out of it just because of the day-to-day use of the injector, the hammering that takes place there, the high loads, you're going to have erosion on that ball seat. Okay, so how can we diagnose it? You commonly hear guys refer to the balance rate test. Now, this is an easy test to perform. It's all electronic. You just plug in the OBD2 port. You can look at an Edge CTS, EFI Live, Tech2, etc. You'll see 8 balance rates, and these numbers are indicative of per cylinder how much fuel is added or subtracted in MM3, which is a volume, to maintain a consistent crankshaft revolution, so a smooth idle. If you see balance rates that are outside of 4 MM3, that's supposed to be an indication to you that you have an issue in the fuel system, probably an injector problem. Okay, bad balance rates can be caused by other things as well. Poor cylinder performance, valves, a whole host of other issues there. But balance rate test is going to give you a pretty good indication on LB7 of whether or not you have injector problems. Again, plus or minus 4 in park or neutral is the number you're looking for. In my experience, if you're getting past 2.5 or 3, you're probably getting there. Fuel in the crankcase is going to cause bearings to get wiped out. It's going to cause all sorts of issues in the engine. We want to find fuel in the crankcase as soon as possible. It's indicative of a high pressure fuel leak in the fuel system. Again, the injectors are under the valve covers. The whole fuel system really is under the valve covers there. So if you have fuel in the crankcase, there's an issue. Long crank when hot, again, leak down, high return rates, taking a while for the injector to come back to life. That's an indicator to you. Again, haze it idle. This is easy to see on trucks on the street. If you see a truck on the street and you're at a stoplight and you see a white haze coming out at idle and it smells like putrid fuel, like unburnt fuel, that's probably an LB7 that needs injectors. Again, none of these issues in and of themselves are going to be directly it needs injectors, but if you see all these issues together, you're probably getting there. Now, there's further diagnostics you can do, of course, but those are going to be the easy ones. How can you fix it? So, fuel system contamination, this is the easiest one to fix. Change your fuel filter regularly. Do not go 50,000 miles or more on a fuel filter. That's ridiculous. It's a $40 part. Change it every other oil change. Use a high quality filter. Change your water separator. Use good fuel. Don't get fuel out of some unknown source because it's cheap. Okay, injectors are expensive, CP3s are expensive, fuel system parts are very expensive. Don't cheap out on fuel. Use an additive. If you doubt the quality of your fuel, use a lubricity additive. That additive is going to help the fuel system perform longer, stave off those issues from wear. So use an additive. I'm not going to recommend one to you, but you can find one, make sure it's tried and true, and make sure it has Lubricity on it somewhere. When you replace the injectors, replace the hard lines. Okay, don't reuse injector hard lines. There's plenty of suppliers out there now who can get you good, cheap, new hard lines for the injectors, and torque them using a torque wrench, for the love of God. Don't ruin a new set of injectors by hammering down the injector lines on a new set of injectors. I think that just about covers it. I'm Nick. This has been Diesel Insights. We'll see you next time. Thanks. If you like these videos and you want to learn more, check out the Diesel Tuners blog, dieseltunersblog.com.